Okay, so now we'll proceed to our question number 1. So here you can go through first question. Please read it carefully and give your correct answer. Okay, first answer is given by Kalyani, is E. And anyone else? Any other answer? Okay, so we'll proceed to our answer, right? So the correct answer is E. Okay, so Kalyani has won the first quiz. Okay, so why it is? Because the nerve fibers in the marginal zone of the developing neural tube that become myelinated and that form the white matter of your spinal cord. So this statement is correct. Okay, so we have to choose the correct answer, right? So what we'll do here, we have to correct all other four things, right? So the A, option A will be the wall of the neural tube that is formed of single layer of your pseudo stratified columnar epithelium, not stratified squamous cells. Then option B will be the neuroblast migrate peripherally to form the intermediate zone. Okay. Then option C will be the repeated division of the matrix cell of the neural tube that results in an increase in the length and diameter of the tube. And option D will be the intermediate zone, not ventricular zone, okay, of the neural tube will form the gray matter of the spinal cord. Okay, so nice try, and we'll proceed to our next question. Okay, so I hope all of you will give the good answer. So here is your question number 2. So you have to choose one exactly correct answer, okay? Okay, Kalyani and Amrita chosen A, fine. Kajal chosen B, fine. Any other? Okay, Divya Sai and Harshita chosen for B, fine. Okay, so we'll proceed to our answer. Your correct answer is B only. Okay, with the neural crest cells, they give rise to the posterior root ganglia. Like that, you know that this neural crest cells that may form your C cells of your thyroid gland, okay, your all the ganglia, the posterior root ganglia, the prevertebral ganglia, the paravertebral ganglia, okay, all these ganglion they actually arise from the neural crest cells. Okay, so to correct all other things, that is the A, the neural crest cells, they are actually formed from the lateral margin of the neural plate, okay, not medial margin. Then the option C, the neural crest cells form the neurons of the autonomic ganglia, okay. And option D will be the Schwann cells of peripheral nerves. Okay. They are actually formed from the neural crest cells. Okay. You have to cut the knot. Okay. Then option E will be the neural crest cells. They form the cells of the medulla. Okay. Not cortex. Okay. So medullary part of the suprarenal gland, that is also formed by your neural crest cells, fine. So all of you have done the good job, and all the best for next question, question number 3. Very easy question, try to answer it. Please remember, only you have 1 minute to think about all these things, right? So you have to answer it quickly. Okay, Ritika opted C. Kalyani chosen A, fine. Any other? Harshita C, Madhurima C, fine. Kalyani काजल एंड अमृता जो चोजन सी ओके सो वी विल प्रोसीड टू आवर करेक्ट आंसर. योर करेक्ट आंसर इज सी. ओके सी इज करेक्ट. इन द एडल्ट द लोअर एंड ऑफ द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड दैट लाइज एट द लेवल ऑफ द लोअर बॉर्डर ऑफ द फर्स्ट लंबर वर्टेब्रा. सो वी हैव टू करेक्ट द अदर ऑप्शंस राइट. द ऑप्शन नंबर ए द आलर प्लेट्स फॉर्म द न्यूरॉन्स इन द पोस्टेरियर ग्रे कॉलम नॉट एंटीरियर. ओके एंड ऑप्शन बी विल बी द नर्व सेल्स ऑफ द सिंपैथेटिक आउटफ्लो दे आर फॉर्म फ्रॉम द बेसल प्लेट्स. ओके देन द ऑप्शन नंबर डी एट बर्थ द लोअर एंड ऑफ द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड दैट लाइज एट द लेवल ऑफ द थर्ड लंबर वर्टेब्रा. ओके देन ऑप्शन ई विल बी द मेनिंजेस ऑफ द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड आर डेवलप्ड फ्रॉम द मेजेनकाइम दैट सराउंड्स द न्यूरल ट्यूब. ओके सो ऑल ऑफ यू हैव गिवन द नाइस आंसर. ऑल द बेस्ट फॉर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. ओके काजल चूजन ए. एनीवन एल्स आई हैव गिवन यू द टॉपिक फ्रॉम वेरी एडवांस 4 आवर्स बिफोर सो यू शुड ट्राई इट. वेदर इट इज करेक्ट और रॉन्ग दैट डजेंट मैटर प्लीज ट्राई इट. And Harshita chosen E, but she is in doubt. Fine. Any others? Kalyani chosen A. Fine. ओके रितिका ऑल्सो चोजन सी. दिव्यसाई ई. ओके फाइन सो विल प्रोसीड टू अवर करेक्ट आंसर. द करेक्ट आंसर इज ए. ओके ए इज करेक्ट. Because the cerebellum that is formed from the dorsal part of the alar plate of the metencephalon. Okay. So we have to correct all other answers. So the option B will be the neurons of the deep cerebellar nuclei. They are derived from the matrix cells. Okay, lining the cavity of the not midbrain, it will be the hindbrain vesicle. Okay, in place of midbrain, you have to only write the hindbrain or vesicle, then the sentence will be correct. Then option C, the neuroblast in the basal plates, okay, not the dorsal plates, that will form the nuclei of the trochlear and the oculomotor nerves. Okay, option D will be the neuroblast of the superior and inferior colliculi. They are formed from the neurocytes in the alar plate, okay, not in the basal plate. Okay, option E will be the pons that arises from the anterior part, okay, of the metencephalon with cellular contributions from the alar part of the myelencephalon. Okay, so good try. We'll proceed to our next question. Next question, question number 5. Okay, Harshita in doubt, but she chosen B. Padarthi Devyasai chosen A. Anyone else? Amrita also B, but in also doubt. Kalyani also in doubt, B or C. Okay. Kajal after D. Okay, what about other students? They are not coming, they are not interested in. So we'll proceed to our correct answer. So the correct answer is D. Okay. So Kajal has opted the D. So good. So here the pars nervosa of the hypophysis actually that is formed from the floor of the diencephalon. This sentence is correct, but we have to correct all other things also. So the optic vesicle that grows out of the forebrain vesicle, okay, not the midbrain vesicle. Then option B will be the thalamus that is formed from the alar plates in the lateral walls of the diencephalon, okay. And option C will be the lamina terminalis. That is formed from the rostral end of the telencephalon, okay, not the diencephalon. And option E will be the hypothalamic nuclei are formed from the alar plates of the diencephalon, not the basal plate. Okay, so all the best for next question, question number 6. First one means which one, Divya Sai? Okay, Harshita is in doubt, A or C, right? Anyone else? Okay, the fifth question, option A, right? So that will be the optic vesicles, okay, that grows out of the forebrain vesicle, not from the midbrain vesicle, okay, because it is the outpouching of your diencephalon, right? Okay, so Kalyani chosen A. Kajal and Ritika opted to D. Oh, Madhurima and Kalyani. Okay, Madhurima D and Kalyani also D, right? What happened, Dibya Sai? Choose your answer, choose your answer. Okay, don't know. Okay, so we'll proceed to our correct answer, right? So those who have given the option D, they have the correct option chosen, okay? So because the pars nervosa of the hypophysis cerebri, that is formed from the floor of the diencephalon, right? Option A, we have to correct it, the optic vesicle, okay? Not the the D is correct, right? Here, okay. So the internal capsule that is formed by the developing ascending and descending tracts growing between the developing thalamus and the caudate nucleus medially and the lentiformally. So it is correct answer, okay? So we have to also correct the option A also. So the option A, here it is written the corpus striatum that is formed from the proliferation of the matrix meaning the floor of the forebrain vesicle, okay, not the roof, okay. And option B, the interventricular foramen that is formed by the cavity of the telencephalon, okay, not the diencephalon. And option C will be the choroid plexus of the lateral ventricle, okay, that is formed by the vascular mesenchyme, not the vascular ectoderm, okay, vascular mesenchyme covered by the ependymal cells, okay. And option E will be the neurons of the cerebral cortex that develop from the matrix cells, okay, lining the cavity of the cerebral hemisphere, and these cells produce the large number of neuroblasts that migrate out into the marginal zone, okay. So here we have done the good job. So we'll proceed to our next question, question number 7. Okay, Dibesai chosen E and Harshita also chosen E. Fine. All of you have chosen E. Fine. Arunima, first time maybe. And Amruta also E. And Kalyani E. Kajal also E. Okay, Yuktishika also E. Fine. And Dibesai also E. And Ritika also chosen E. So all of you have chosen E. Fine. Okay, so we'll proceed to the correct answer. Good. So all of you are on the question number 7. In the developing brain, the myelination that is carried out by the oligodendrocytes and not by the neurons. Okay. So we have to correct the A. So in the developing brain, myelination begins at about the 6th month of the fetal life. Okay. And option B will be, in the developing brain, the sensory fibers, they are actually myelinated first. Option C will be the myelination of the nerve tracts, that is not haphazard, but that is systemic. Okay, systematic, occurring in different nerve fibers at the specific time. And option D will be the myelination of the nerve tracts that is largely complete by the end of the second year. Okay, so all of you have done good job. We will proceed to next question, question number 8. This is also very nice, very easy. Please try to answer like your question number 7. Okay, Harshita, Amruta and Harshita chosen C, Amruta E, Ritika D and Dibyasai chosen B. Fine. Any other answer? Okay, Kajal chosen A. Yes, it is birth defect only. Okay, so we'll proceed to our answer, right? So your correct answer is A. Okay, so A is correct. The spina bifida, that is one of the more common congenital anomalies of the central nervous system. So we have to correct all others. B will be the option. B will be the most common form of spina bifida is your spina bifida occulta. Okay, the term is spina bifida occulta, right? Okay, so option C, the spina bifida that occurs most often in the lower thoracic, lumbar and sacral. Okay, and option D will be in the myelocele, okay, the neural tube that fails to close in the region of the defect. Okay, in option E, most causes of the spina bifida occulta requires no treatment. Okay, nice try. We'll proceed to our next question, question number 9. So here you have to go through a case study. So a 6 month old girl was seen by the plastic surgeon because of the presence of a swelling at the root of the nose. Okay, the mother said that she had noticed the swelling when the child was born, and that since then it had gradually increased in size. Okay, so now we come. Okay, so just read the question number 9 and answer according to the case history. Okay, Amrita chosen B. The swelling was located between the frontal and nasal bone. Fine. Padarthi Divya Sai chosen A. The swelling was situated at the root of the nose in the midline. Okay. C, the swelling was fluctuant and no gentle pressure could be reduced in size. Okay. Any other answer? Okay, Kajal opted for C. The swelling was fluctuant and on gentle pressure could be reduced the size. Okay. Aronima also C. Kalyani also C. Fine. So we'll proceed to our correct answer. The correct answer is E. Okay. So E is the exception here. Okay, every sign and symptom you will find in that baby. Okay, but the pulse that did not coincide with the pulse felt over the anterior frontality of the skull, that is actually exception, okay, that will not include in all these signs and symptoms. So this A is exception because in a cephalic meningocele, okay, meningocele means meninges that will be protruded out like it will be bulging out along with the cerebrospinal fluid, okay. So the cerebrospinal fluid within this swelling, that is the in direct communication with that in the subarachnoid space, okay. So the pulsation of the swelling that is produced by the pulse wave of the cerebral arteries through the CSF. So this pulse wave will coincide with the pulse that is felt over the anterior frontality of the skull, okay. So E will be the correct answer, that is the exception. So we'll proceed to our next question, question number 10, okay. The case history is same, but you read the question number 10. The neurosurgeon was consulted and the following possible additional findings were ascertained except one thing, okay. What is that thing you have to choose? Okay, Kajal opted for B. The defect in the membranous bones is known as craniosynthesis. Okay. Any other? Amruta chosen E. Brain tissue is never found within the hernia. Okay. Okay, Kajal changed to E. Fine. Okay, Arunima also chosen E, fine. Good, Ritika and Harshita also chosen E. Okay, so all of you are correct over here, okay. So this is the exception, right. In the craniosynthesis, that is actually characterized by a defect in the membranous bone of the skull, okay, through which what will find the meninges or the meninges and the neural tissue that may protrude out, okay. The defect that usually occurs in the midline in the occipital region or between the frontal and nasal bone. So this condition is probably the result of your anomalous formation and separation of the neural tube from the surface ectoderm of the embryo, okay. So each exception and you have done nice job, so good. So here we have completed the embryology part. Now we will proceed to the cerebrum, okay. So the first question of the cerebrum will be this. So please give quick answer. We will not delay over here in cerebrum, because you have completed so many times about the cerebrum. Okay, here also you have to choose the correct statement. Okay, here you will see all these statements that is concerned with a correct statement, numbered statement that you have to choose. Okay, so start here. Okay, Kajal Amrita chosen B. Madhurima S. What is this? S. Okay, Arindita chosen B. Anyone else? Okay, Harshita, Madhurima, Arandita, all they have chosen B. Fine. So we'll proceed to our correct answer. Our correct answer is B. All of you have done the nice job, right? B is correct. Okay. The diencephalon that is bounded laterally by the internal capsule. So we have to correct all others that the A, the diencephalon that extends anteriorly as far as the interventricular foramen. Option C, the thalamus is situated on the lateral wall of the third ventricle. Option D, the epithalamus consists of the habenular nuclei and their connections and the pineal gland. Option E will be the diencephalon that extends posteriorly as far as the cerebral aqueduct. Okay, so good job. We will proceed to our next question, question number 2. Please answer it quickly. Easy question. Okay, Joyce, first time given the answer. B. Joyce, option B. Okay, all they have chosen B. Fine. Arshita, Ruchita, Dibhyasai, Ritika, Arandita, Amrita, all the chosen B. Okay. So, the correct answer is B only. Okay. So, what we will do here, we will correct all other options. The option A, the pineal secretions that are actually translucent to X-ray, not opaque. Okay. Option C, the melatonin inhibits the release of the gonadotrophic hormone from the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland. And option D, that will be there is an increased production of the secretion of the pineal gland during the darkness. And option E, the pinealocytes, okay, they are actually stimulated by the sympathetic nerve endings. So we have done good job. We'll proceed to our next question, question number 3. Okay, give quick answers. We don't have any time. Today's will be your last MCQ discussions on neuroanatomy. Okay, Divya Sai will choose an A. Fine. Go ahead. We'll complete fast. Okay, Arunima also A. Okay, Kajal, Ruchita, Harshita, Ritika, all they have chosen A. Fine. Arandita also A. Okay, fine. Then we will proceed to our correct answer. The correct answer is A. All of you have done the good job. The thalamus is the largest part of the diencephalon and serves as the relay station to all the main sensory tract except the olfactory pathway. Okay, so we'll correct all other options. The thalamus is separated from the lentiform nucleus by the internal capsule, not the external capsule. And option C, the thalamus forms the posterior boundary of the interventricular foramen. Okay, and option D, the thalamus may be joined to the thalamus of the opposite side by the interthalamic connection. Okay, and option E, the thalamus is a large overt mass of gray matter, okay, not rectangular mass. Okay. So, we'll proceed to our next question. Question number 4. All of you have done nice job. Please go ahead. Because you have exams, no? I don't want to give more load on your study. You have to go through other subjects also. That's why we'll finish today's MCQs over here. If you have time, then you can tell me. Okay, Harshita, chosen D. Quick. Amrita, D. Kajal, D. And Arunima also chosen D. Okay, Madhurima, Ritika, Kalyani, Joyce, all they opted for D. Fine. So we'll proceed to our correct answer. Your correct answer is D only. Okay. So we have to correct all other options. The hypothalamus that is formed by the lower part of the lateral wall and the floor of the third ventricle below the hypothalamic sulcus. And option B, you'll find caudally, the hypothalamus merges with the tegmentum of the midbrain. Okay. And option C will be the nuclei of the hypothalamus are composed of group of small nerve cells, and option E, the mammillary bodies are part of the hypothalamus. Okay, so nice job. We'll proceed to next question. Question number 5. All of you are doing great job. Thanks for participating. Please go ahead. Okay, any answer? Okay, so Dibyasai, Harshita, Dibyasai chosen D, Harshita C, Kajal C and Ritika D. Fine. Any others? Okay, Kalyani C, Arunima also C, Amrita C, fine. Arandita also C. Anuradha D. Where are you? Anuradha. Ruchita C and Madhurima C. Fine. Okay, so we'll proceed to our correct answer. Your correct answer is C. Okay. So we have to correct all other options. So here you see the option A. That will be the hypothalamus has influence on the activities of the autonomic and endocrine systems. And option B will be the hypothalamus receives many afferent visceral and somatic sensory nerve fibers. Option D will be the hypothalamus assists in the regulation of water metabolism. And option E will be the hypothalamus plays a role in controlling emotional states. Okay, so nice job. Please go ahead with next question. Question number 6. Please answer it quickly. If you are liking this type of MCQs, please press the like button. No, till now nobody has liked. Whether you like this video or not, I don't know. Okay, so Kajal opted A, Harshita also chosen A. Fine. Madhurima also A. And Ritika, Anuradha, Kajal, chosen A. And Joyce, D. Okay, then we'll proceed to our correct answer. Your correct answer is A. Okay, 6 that A is correct. So we have to correct all other options. So see here the B, that the third ventricle that does communicate directly with the lateral ventricles through the interventricular foramen. Okay, so you have to cut only knot. Okay. So it does communicate, right? Then option C will be the vascular telecoroidea that projects from the roof of the third ventricle to form the choroid plexus, okay, not the floor. Then option D, that is lying in the floor of the third ventricle, okay, from the anterior to posterior are the optic chiasma, the tuber cinereum body. Okay. Then option E Okay, that will be the wall of the third ventricle is lined with ependymema. Okay, so we have to cut only knot. Okay, fine. So we'll proceed to next question. Question number 7. So here you have to do the matchmaking, right? So you have to identify the number that is marked over here in this picture. Okay. And you have to match this number with the particular A, B, C, D or E. You may choose in multiple options also. So let's try here. Okay, last time Arandita also taken part, the D. Okay, Kajal chosen 7A means the one option is, where is the one? Okay, one is of corpus callosum. Okay, Anuradha 5C. Okay, 5C body of fornix. Okay, fine. Harshita chosen A. Okay, Anuradha 7A. Why you cannot see? Maybe you are using your mobile, right? Okay. So Harshita 7A, Harshita set C, Jayesh 12B. Okay, interventricular foramen. Okay, Kajal 1D, Ruchita 8C, 8C, okay. Fine. Amrita 1D, Ruchita 7D, Arandita 7A, Kajal 5C and Arandita also 5C and Arandita also 6B, fine. Okay, you will be surprised when I will say you the answer. Okay, so we'll proceed to our correct answer. Remember, the number 1 what is presented over here, that is actually anterior commissure. Okay, anterior commissure. Then the number 2 that is marked over there, that is the genu of your corpus callosum. Okay, and number 3 that is actually related none of the above. There is no option over here. Okay, so here the question number 9. Okay, that is actually the structure, this that is present over here is actually your septum pellucidum. Okay, that is not present over here. So it is none of the above. Okay, septum pellucidum number 3. Okay, question number 9 or marked number 3 as a septum pellucidum. And number 4 is your interventricular foramen. Okay, that you can see over here. And question number 5 that is body of the fornix. Okay, body of the fornix. Number 6, that is also none of the above. Means here this 6 marked number, okay, that area is the structure of the thalamus. Okay, so thalamus is not present over here, so it is none of the above. Okay, and the question number 13, which is marked as a 7, that is also none of the above. Okay, because the structure here marked in number 7, actually that is the splenium of the corpus callosum. Okay, so you have done the nice job. So we'll proceed to our next question, question number 14. Okay, so choose the correct answer over here. Okay, so we'll proceed to our answer. So the correct answer will be the 14D. Okay, 14D is correct. So we'll just make other options correct, that is the A. Okay, that is the longitudinal cerebral fissure that contains a fold of dura mater and the fox cerebri, and option B will be the longitudinal cerebral fissure that doesn't contain the middle cerebral arteries. They are located in the lateral cerebral fissures, and option C, the superior sagittal venous sinus that lies above the longitudinal cerebral fissure. And option E will be the inferior sagittal venous sinus that lies in the lower border of the fox cerebri in the longitudinal cerebral fissure. Okay, so we'll proceed to our next question, question number 15. Okay, it's for medical lecture. Who is commented that the question number 3 in adult spinal cord and at the lower border of L2. Sir, you are correct. Sir or madam, you are correct. Actually, that depends from patient to patient. So here naturally the spinal cord it adds in the level of L2, but sometimes it may comes towards the L3 also, and sometimes it ends at the L1 level also. Okay, so you are absolutely correct. Okay, Jayesh chosen D, Arunima A, and Padarthi Dibyasai also A. Ritika and Kajal, they also chosen A, fine. Okay, Madhurima also chosen A. Any other answer? Okay, so we'll proceed to our correct answer. Our correct answer is your A. Okay, so the cerebral the central sulcus that extends onto the medial surface of the cerebral hemisphere. Okay, so you have to correct all other answers, that is D. Option B, that will be the frontal lobe lies anterior to the central sulcus, and option C will be the parietal lobe that lies posterior to the central sulcus, and option D will be the central sulcus that is not continuous inferiorly with the lateral sulcus, and option E will be the arachnoid matter that doesn't extend into the central sulcus. Okay, so you have done nice job. We'll proceed to our next question, question number 16. Okay, so Dibyasai chosen B, Arunima also B, Kajal B, Amrita, Rochita, Jayesh, Arandita, Ritika, all they chosen for B. Okay, so okay, we'll proceed to the correct answer. The correct answer is actually B. All of you have done the good job. So we'll just do the other options, we'll correct the other options. So option A, that is each lateral ventricle is actually C-shaped, okay, not the J-shaped, and that is filled with the cerebrospinal fluid. Option C, the body of the lateral ventricle occupies the parietal lobe. And option D will be the lateral ventricle that does possess a choroid plexus. and option E, the anterior horn of the lateral ventricle that occupies the frontal lobe, okay, not the parietal lobe. So you have done good job. We'll proceed to next question, question number 17. Okay, try to answer it quickly. Okay, Ruchita opted for C. Kajal also C. Okay, Amrita, Ritika, Divya Sai, Arandita all chosen C. Fine. Jayesh also C. Fine. Okay, so we'll proceed to our correct answer. The correct answer is C. Good job, all of you are doing very nicely. So here just we'll rectify the other options. The corpus callosum, that is actually connected to the fornix by the septum pellucidum. Okay, and option B, the rostrum of the corpus callosum that connects the genu to the lamina terminalis. And option D will be the fibers of the genu of the corpus callosum that curve forward into the frontal lobes of the cerebral hemisphere as the forceps minor. And option E will be the corpus callosum that is related to superiorly to the fox cerebri. Okay. So, nice job. We'll proceed to next question, question number 18. Okay, Arunima also chosen C, but okay, try to answer it quickly. We have only 4-5 questions. We'll complete today. Okay, Kajal opted for D. Arindita also D, fine. Arunima also D, fine. Any other? Jayesh also D, fine. Okay, so we'll proceed to our correct. Our correct answer is B. Okay, B is correct. So when the anterior commissure is traced laterally, an anterior bundle of nerve fibers that is seen to curve forward to join the olfactory tract. So we have to correct all other options. Option A, the anterior commissure, it is embedded in the superior part of the lamina terminalis. Okay, and option C, some of the fibers of the anterior commissure are concerned with the sensation of smell. And option D, the anterior boundary of the interventricular foramen is formed by the anterior pillar of the fornix and not the anterior commissure. Option E, the anterior commissure is formed by the small bundle of nerve fibers, not the large bundle. Okay. So, we will proceed to our next question, question number 19. Okay, Ruchita and Ritika also answered, but they given late answer. You have only 1 minute. Yes, yes. Okay, Jayesh chosen B. Dibyasai D. Amrita chosen B and Arandita also B. Arunima also B, fine. Okay, so we'll proceed to our correct answer. Your correct answer is C. C is correct. The internal capsule contains the pulvar and corticospinal fibers in the genu and the anterior part of the posterior limb. So just we will correct all other options. A, option A, that will be the internal capsule is continuous below with the cross cerebri of the midbrain. Option B, the internal capsule is bent around the lentiform nucleus and has an anterior limb, the genu and a limb. And option D, the internal capsule that is related laterally to the lentiform nucleus. And option E, the internal capsule, it is continuous above with the corona radiata. Okay, so we'll proceed to next question, question number 20. Okay, Kajal chosen E. Okay, Padarthi Dibyasai E. Joyous also E, fine. Okay, so we'll proceed to our correct answer. Your correct answer is B. Okay, the corpus triatum. Okay. So here B is correct because the corpus triatum that is concerned with the control of your muscular movement. Okay. And option A, the head of the caudate nucleus is attached to the lentiform nucleus. Okay. And option C will be the lentiform nucleus is to the external capsule. And option D will be the lentiform nucleus is wedge shaped. Okay. Not oval shaped. As seen on the horizontal section. And option E will be the amygdaloid nucleus that forms one of the basal ganglia. Okay. So we'll proceed to next question. So here you have to do the matchmaking again. Okay. You're matching the questions. So here you have to following questions. We'll give a picture over here. And you have to match the answers according to that. Okay. So here you just do that. Okay, Divya Sai chosen 2C. That number 2 is your lentiform nucleus. Okay, any other answer? This is your last question. Please try to answer it quickly. Okay. Kajal also chosen 2C. And Ruchita 2C and 4E. Okay. Amrita 2A. 2A. Okay. And Kajal 5E. 5E. Okay. Amrita 2A. Okay, Dibyasai 3A and Arandita 5E. Fine. Okay, I think 3 is optic tract. 3, number 3 is optic tract. Okay. And Arandita 2C. Fine. Any other answers? Kajal 3E, okay. 3 A and 5 E is opted by Ruchita. Fine. Okay, so we'll proceed to our answers. Okay, so here the number 1, here it is given, the question number 21. So none of the above, because the marked 1 is the structure of the genu of your corpus callosum. Okay, and number 2, okay, that is C, lentiform nucleus. Okay, and number 3, that is question number 23, here you will find none of the above, because here this marked question is the structure, that is the posterior horn of the lateral ventricle. Okay, so number 3 mark here, right, that is the posterior horn of the lateral ventricle. And number 4, the correct answer will be the structure that presented over here is your third ventricle. Okay, and the number 5, the question number 25, the correct answer also the E, none of the above, because this exact answer will be the anterior column of the fornix. Okay, so all of you have done the good job, so thanks for